Now, this is the story of the Diamond D and the Dangerous Dragon. Now, there are a lot of D words in this story, so you listen very carefully for them. Once upon a time, there lived in a castle a very dignified duke.
Yes, Duke David is my name, and I have a daughter named Dora, who is a delightful damsel.
Here comes Dora, dancing through the door. She's wearing a dress with daisies on it.
Hello, Daddy.
Dora, my delightful daughter, I have a present for you, because you are so delightful.
Aw, do tell, Daddy.
Here is a letter D, made of solid diamonds. You may wear it around your neck. It stands for Dora.
It also stands for delightful.
Dora, may I put the bracelet around your delightful neck?
Oh, please do, yes.
Okay, thank you, Duke.
Yes.
Just put it around your neck and you'll look absolutely beautiful.
Oh, yes, I'm sure.
There.
Oh, it's dandy.
Do you love it?
Yes.
And with that, Duke David departed.
Through the door. The door. That's another good D word. And don't you forget it.
Okay, Duke. And Dora danced out, too.
Lovely, fella. Didi, I'm going into the garden to dance around and dig the day.
You do that, Dora. Now, neither the Duke nor Dora knew that someone else lived in their castle. His name was Donald.
Ha, ha, ha!
And Donald was a dragon.
I am Donald, the Dangerous Dragon.
Now, Donald the Dangerous Dragon lived in a dungeon under the house.
Yeah, it's a deep dungeon.
It's a deep, dark dungeon.
It's a deep, dark, damp dungeon.
It's a deep, dark, damp, dusty dungeon.
It's a deep, dark, damp, dusty, depressing dungeon.
It's a deep, dark, damp, dusty, depressing, disorderly dungeon.
It's a deep, dark, damp, depressing, disorderly, disgusting dungeon.
Is that enough of that?
Definitely.
Good. Now, the best thing that you could say about Donald, the dangerous dragon, was that, he used a lot of D words. Otherwise, he wasn't really very nice at all.
Doggone right. And right now I'm here to steal that pretty diamond D, which Duke David gave to his daughter Dora. And here she comes now.
Now Dora, Duke David's daughter, danced through the door and saw Donald the dangerous dragon. And she said,
"Well, hello, little doggy."
Doggy?
Doggy, that's what I said.
Listen, Dora, dignified Duke David's daughter, thinks that I, Donald the Dangerous Dragon, am a doggy.
Yeah, I know.
Dora, Duke David's daughter, is a dummy.
My goodness, you are the dearest little doggy I have ever seen.
Excuse me.
Not only is she a dummy, she's also a ding-a-ling.
If you will come and live in our house, little doggy, I will give you this diamond D, which my daddy gave to me.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
I didn't think I'd get it that easily.
But just then, in came dignified Duke David. He was carrying a stick.
Oh, no.
Carrying a stick may not be dignified for a duke, but it comes in handy when you meet a dangerous dragon.
And with that, Duke David chased the dragon Donald all around the grounds. The dragon ducked, and he dodged, and he darted. And finally, the Duke dumped the dragon in the duck pond.
Done.
I don't know. He sure looked like a doggy to me.
So to punish Donald, the Duke made the following decree.
From now on, this dangerous dragon has to live in a doghouse, eat dog biscuits, and play like a doggy to amuse my daughter. Or else...
Or else what?
Or else I'll dump you in the duck pond again.
Yo, bow wow.
And so, Dora, the Duke's daughter, and David the dignified Duke, and their not-so-dangerous doggy Donald lived happily ever after. And I'll bet that you didn't even know there were so many D-words. Did you?